If you're like me, you design anywhere and everywhere and on any device you can get your hands on, whether it's your home computer, your work computer, your tablet device, your phone, whatever it may be. And if you are like me, then that means that sometimes you get frustrated because you left the logo on this computer or you can't remember the certain hexadecimal or RGB or CMYK values of the brand colors that you're working on. So that's where Creative Cloud comes in. Creative Cloud is basically a cloud storage system, but for creatives or for creative projects. So it gives you a lot more options for creative assets than it would for, let's say, a spreadsheet or a Word document or a PowerPoint presentation. So it does a lot more than just storing assets. It actually helps you to see which assets were used, what fonts were used, what colors were used and their hexadecimal values, etc. So you can access your Creative Cloud libraries from either online in your Adobe account, or you can access it in the Creative Cloud Libraries panel in any application, whether it's Illustrator, Animate, Photoshop, etc. So when I come in here to the online version, when you log into your Adobe account, you click on your name and you should be able to click Creative Cloud Files. Now, if this website is updated, and I swear it gets updated like every other day, then you might need to look around for where this is, but you should be able to find somewhere in your account where you can log into your Creative Cloud Files. Once you do that, you can upload your logo files, you can do mobile creations with the different small Adobe apps, which are amazing on your phone or tablet, or you can go to your Creative Cloud libraries where you have libraries and assets saved for different projects. So as you can see, I have a library here for my animation assets, for a project for a Rising Up Homeless Shelter, Platte River Brewery, Vino and Drico, they're doing a website and this is their logo information. So anyway, if I go into any one of these, I can see the color palette that I use. So these are the branding colors. I have the different font files I downloaded from defont.com and I have some of the image assets. And this is true for all of those different libraries. So if I go into Vina and Drico, then I can see the logo, I can see the color palette. And if I go into my animation assets, you can actually see some of the stock photos that I was using for these particular animation projects. And the cool thing is if you're in Adobe Illustrator and let's say I was designing this logo, and don't judge my logo designing process, it looks like chaos, but this is just, I never throw anything away when I'm designing a logo because you never know when something will start to gel, so don't judge. But this is really helpful for me because if I accidentally leave this on this home computer and then I want to talk to the client and all I have is my tablet with me and we kind of want to change some colors or whatnot, I have all of these assets in the Adobe Creative Cloud libraries. In addition, if I wanted to go and make an animation related to this, I can go into Adobe Animate CC and go into my CC libraries panel and look for the Platte River Brewery library, and there you can see my color assets, my fonts, and the different graphics that I added to that library. So in this particular tutorial video, I also want to show you how to add assets to that. Now with Adobe Animate, it's a little bit weird because it's not really meant to kind of create graphics and put them in your library. It's really just meant to get assets for your animation projects. So if you're in something like Adobe Illustrator, what you need to do is just click on a color and then you can click here to add that color, or click on a font and you can click here to add that font, and you can create a different character style and click here to add that paragraph or character style, and then you can also click a graphic and either drag it there or add it using this. So anyway, if you ever want to update or refresh a Creative Cloud library, you can always double click this little library button. Even if it says the libraries are up to date, sometimes that's a lie, it's a liar. So you just have to double click and it will update it. So if we come in here, let's go into our animation assets, and let's say I don't dig this game background that I have going on over here. Then what I can do is search for an Adobe stock photo. So let's just type in a basic game background. And the cool part about this is once I find a good background, and I like this one because it doesn't make sense for an apple to be skateboarding in a place with no apple trees. It's like it's running away from its home. Anyway, so I'm going to go ahead and grab this apple graphic, and there's two things I can do. I can either click the shopping cart, and that's going to allow me to purchase this asset, and then it'll actually download into that library, and then I can drag it into my game, and that's how I actually got this asset. Or I can just click this Save Preview to Animation Assets, and it's going to save that preview in here. And what this is going to do is it's going to actually put that picture in there, but with the Adobe stock little logo mark. So what I can do is go ahead and create a new layer, and I will drag this onto the stage. It's going to say, okay, what do you want to do? Do you want to select all the layers in that? Yep, that's fine. Do I want to put it on a single animate layer? Yes. Import as a single bitmap image. Sure, let's go ahead and try that and click import. And there we go. So this is going to allow me, and I have to actually have the right tool. This is going to allow me to kind of see if this is actually the asset I want. So I can link this and make it bigger. And it's going to give you a really pixelated kind of low quality asset. And that is absolutely okay when you're just kind of seeing if this is what you actually want to use for your background. So once I have that in there and maybe put it underneath. Yeah, I think it's fine right there. So then I can preview and watch the little guy skateboarding and decide if this is something I really want to purchase. If it is something I want to purchase, I can right click and choose license image, and I can choose use document, edit, share link, etc., etc. So the other cool thing about this is if, or let's say that Platte River Brewery logo I was working on with another person, I can actually hit this little plus button and add their email address so we can share the same folder. So if I was sharing something with, you know, let's say a college marketing department and we needed to share assets for a project, this is a really easy way to allow them to collaborate with me and view things and whatnot. So Creative Cloud Library is pretty awesome. Sometimes they get annoying because anytime you create a new color, it tries to add it to a library. But this is basically what it's trying to do. It's trying to save it for you on a cloud storage system so that you can access it from anywhere, any device, and any application.